Another common need in building such situation awareness applications is that a computation may need to get correspondingly time-stamped items from several different sensor sources. So for instance, in this picture, I'm showing a video source, an audio source, a text source, and gesture source. And this computation, in order to do its high-level inferencing, it wants to use the multiple modalities of sensing that's available to generate higher-level inference that can be more robust. And this is where bundling of streams that PTS allows comes in handy. PTS allows streams to be grouped together as a stream group, and any number of such streams can be grouped together and labeled as a group. And in creating a stream bundle like this, a computation can specify that for this stream group, this guy is the anchor stream. For instance, we could name the video as the anchor stream for this particular stream group. All the other streams within the same stream group are dependent streams on the anchor stream. And in PTS, there is a primitive for getting a group get, saying get corresponding time-stamped items from all of the streams in a particular stream group. The group get primitive is once again a way of reducing the pain point for a domain expert in having to go out and fetch individual items from each one of these streams and selecting temporally correlated items from all the other dependent streams. That burden is taken away by PTS by providing this group get, where you can get correspondingly time-stamped items from all the streams in a given group.